If Bernal had, by the way, did you get a chance to look at the biography of JD Bernal?
No.
I had the book. It's really wonderful. I met Andrew Brown in Dublin, and he's a wonderful guy. But if Bernal hadn't been so pro-Stalin, he probably would have won a Nobel Prize. I'm pretty sure of that. He's a remarkable man, though. Mm-hmm. Do you know that Churchill, he was advisor to Churchill. And Churchill knew he was a communist. It's an incredible thing. I guess it's sort of like people who felt about Oppenheimer. You know, General Groves was not stupid. He said, I don't care if he's a communist or not. He's a great physicist. So that's the way it was, I guess. I suppose that Einstein was probably accused of being, if not a communist, a Marxist. Huh? I don't know enough about him. But so, and as I mentioned, it's the Benzema, because Bernal was, as I said, was also a Sephardic name, at the, as was others. So I tried to find out if Derek had ever had any personal contact with Bernal, and it turns out he was not. He didn't get his. He went to the University of London, but he didn't get his degree under Bernal. He just may have known about
him. He knew him.
But he didn't actually have any dealings with him when he was younger. So I don't know what when he first encountered the social function of science, but. I encountered it early on because my uncle had given me a copy of that book. And then when I went to the University of Colorado, when we were talking about science and the war and everything like that, Bernal's name came up. People knew about him then, but only from that book, because nobody was hearing about him during the war. He was working probably secretly. How open he was during the time of the war, because he was just too busy.